Welcome to the Auto Evo Intelligent Braking System app. Introduction of the Auto Evo Braking System. The Auto Evo Braking System is an app developed to teach about the brakes that Auto Evo Braking System is making. It is an intelligent braking system app used as a marketing tool. Basically what it does, it demonstrates what the brakes actually do. It's being developed by Pilot Engineering Evolution. I am the founder of Pilot Engineering Evolution. How to begin? What I did is I looked into the atomic design. How this worked is that I had to come up with the full atom. I had to develop it from organisms to molecules, and then from molecules I went into templates, which I put all the colors that I had developed from the atom into the templates, and then from the templates and then we went on to making the pages of the design. So let's go through the process of how I made that. Let's go through the whole process and break it all down, starting from here. I had all the pictures from the personas of other apps, and I put it all together so that I could come up with the most reasonable part. So basically this was the molecule stage that I was doing at that time, but at the same time also working on the organisms stage, which are also persona. These are narrowed down of the pictures from the personas to actually develop the colors I needed to put together to make the atom. So this is the atom over here that's now been made up, and it's ready to, we now got colors that we can use within the app itself in Figma. So after developing the atom, then looked into making up the pages. Started off with the frames and filled up the frames, and the frames, this is then came into the templates. The templates are, you know, are also sets that you actually download to, you know, fit into your frames. Now after making up the frames, then develop the pages. It may not look exactly like this, but you know, these were the starting stages. Even the titles also have changed, the logo has also blended into the app itself on the pages. These are the titles that were now put onto Figma and link them all together to follow the buttons. Now setting up the button was not such a fair game, because all it was trying to choose the proper way to make it work and choose the buttons that were, you know, useful and easier to use, and also make it exciting for somebody to follow and read and not make it such a boring thing to follow. Now Figma, I will then expound what I did in Figma, and then from Figma then we go into what we actually ended up into the Unity itself. So let's restart with the Figma app itself. We are now in Figma. Now on here it's now all looking all smart, you know, like the presentive app now, because it came out from the pages and we've now, you know, come up to this look. I mean the looks now. We now got the, obviously the titles have changed. Now go electric car. In the electric car, you can scroll and read everything that is, you know, explaining about our electric cars. Then also, you go through reading about the intelligent braking system, the Auto Evo itself. Then you go into the Auto Evo system as a company, how it exists and things like that in there. Then you got the SIM. Obviously SIM cannot really work with the Figma, Then you go call for action. It expounds about the future and how it should be, you know, run. That's what the call for action was there for. And then you have this part where it's booting from, and it lands up on this stage. This stage usually is only when the app is first started, and it will stop here. Then from there you go on to the, then it will give you this. This is the app itself and how it is actually working on our Figma when it's fully developed. If we had to, you know, move this one into Unity, as this is the final product in Figma, we are still have a lot to make the app look this type in Unity. There are stages and still working through it. It's a process, a quite a big app, and there's a lot of work to still be done, but I'll take you through to what work we have, what I have achieved so far with the Unity right now. In Unity, this is sort of like the loading part of the Unity, and it should start in any second now to load up. There it goes, loading up 100%. Well, why have we got this here? Basically, one, it is, you know, anybody who knows the trade quite well, they're known as a veteran in that trade. And, basically, I am basically going to be developing this technology, so I'll be a veteran in this technology as we, got the cutting edge technology that we evolve between the brakes and the brakes itself in the industry. So that's why we call ourselves, we're going to call veterans in technologies. And also, we've got some people may say, oh, it's come from a game, but this is the interesting part, is that got this here because we are changing the game. We are changing the game. Evolution means to evolve from something and go into something better. So we evolve, evolution, parallax engineering evolution, just so that we change in the game. All right, so we go into begin. So now begin, we sort of seen this type of menu earlier on in the Figma, but this has not been actually adapted to that as yet, so we can look exactly, it's in the stages where we are trying it to change it, so it looks like exactly like, you know, like in the Figma. Because the Figma is really an outstanding template and structure, the way they look like. You want to structure this one here into the same thing. So it's got the similar things where you get the explanation. Obviously, it's taking that, it's extrapolating it from that Figma into this one. So it's got all that, as the same as that. You know, that's about, goes into here. Into that as well, which is continuously to teach about the breaks, the product as well, right? Same things I have. The interaction obviously couldn't work in Figma, but here it will obviously be working. So we'll go, right, and push it maybe halfway and see, you know. We want to make their forces equal and opposite. So to make them equal and opposite, so they can stop, put pull out and pull out. And there you see it's coming to a stop. So that's why it is, they're equal 100%, 100% going in the opposite of each other. They'll come to a hold. You see, that's how this app is demonstrating. So with that, we managed to develop the app in this stage. Now, looking at the whole structure, that was from the Figma into this stage, which is the Unity stage. So with that, that's a whole sort of app developed in stages, come from Figma to this, from the atomic structure to this. It's been a journey between the in between the whole process. It's been quite a journey, and it still continues to be a journey, because there's still a lot to be developed and a lot of changes to make this uplift and look better. This app, there's still a lot to do, and it's still going to continue to be worked on until it becomes a proper nice marketing tool. Yes, with that, I will then take you to back to the stages where we're looking at. So if we move it today, it shows you all the other development, how the development stage, the development stages, where you're gonna get all the what you call the scenes in here, which are put together, and then obviously goes into the build stage here. So one would wonder what is actually happening, but if you go into the build settings, you'll find that these are the ones that are in the build settings, and obviously to build and run these into, when you build and run them, they come up like that. The loading one, there's no, the one that says logo, like here, I've taken that out, so that I can have that in there with just a loading and works through, because I found no reason for keeping the logo there. So when we come into here, we're gonna build and run. It's gonna build and run and then go. That's basically what this would do, and at this stage, so it's basically nearly working and functional, but it's not really appealing the way we want. So there's still a lot of work to be done on this app itself. Interested to know more, please feel free to contact me, and thank you for watching.